Hello and welcome to Sports Gaming Universe channel here on YouTube, and welcome back to the Russ Courtnell Be a Pro series here in NHL 16 on the Xbox One. Now, Russ Courtnell had a rough go of it in the last episode. He was cruising right along in the first handful of games for the Arizona Coyotes when, the team leader in points got sent down to the minors. Very rude awakening right there, but he's trying to make the most of it here with the Springfield Falcons, and we're jumping into another set of games today, taking on the Rochester Americans, and no score. That shot on net is put aside to the corner. Courtnell finds it, and a nice pass in front across the crease, and it's put home. Courtnell will get the second helper on that goal as Springfield takes the 1-0 lead. Great effort right there to follow his shot into the corner, make this pass to a teammate who then fed it across the crease. And the goal right there. So nice play by Springfield to strike first in this hockey game. Another look at it. Goalie has no chance, really. 1-0. Let's see if we can continue on here as we go further into the first period. You got a line change coming up. Courtnell all over the boards. And he gets on the ice just in time to watch the equalizer go in the net. The Americans get the goal. It's Irwin getting the tally. And you see the replay since we couldn't really see it. We were just getting off the bench. Figured I'd run the replay. I don't usually show too many of the opposing team's goals, but since we had no clue what happened, thought I'd cue that up. So it's a 1-1 game now, halfway through the first. A chance there, and that's a save on Courtnell's shot. This goes around the boards, but kept in by Springfield. Pass in front. Oh, it's in the skates. They're going to work this around. The shot on net. It goes in, and it's tipped in front, and it's going to be Courtnell's goal, making it 2-1. Believe he got the deflection and should get credit for the second Springfield goal. Yes, it is Courtnell time. He tallies another here in his hope to return back to the NHL ice soon. Make some impressions down here, turn some heads, and a deflection goal right in front right there will certainly help his case with the Arizona Brass. Although I do have to say, I still think it's quite ridiculous and arbitrary that he's down here in the first place. He was leading the team in points. Who cares if he missed a few of his goals? As far as I would imagine, defense was the thing hurting him the most. Here are some more chances. Puck will not go in the net, but they continue to cycle this around. Big saves, and there's a goal. And guess who it is? It's big John Scott. Yep, the MVP of the NHL All-Star Game, playing minor league hockey down here with us, and he gets the goal. Yeah, this is, of course, before Arizona traded him away or was forced to trade him away or whatever you believe the NHL put pressure on them to do in the John Scott saga. But there he is, scoring a goal for the Springfield Falcons. It's now 3-1. Thank you, John Scott. But guess what? The Americans say this is not done, not even close. They get their second goal, make it 3-2. And here they come again, putting pressure on midway through the game. That pass and the shot is going to go in the net. The slapper beats the goalie, and it's 3-3. Yeah, not done yet. Second period almost over, but the Americans still on the charge, bringing this around the glass behind the net and in front, and beats him short side, stick side. And just like that, Rochester's taking the lead 4-3, but the period's not over, and that slides into the net. Oh my goodness, is it time for a goaltending change? This just got ridiculous. It's 5-3. There's about 6 minutes left in the game. Turnover. And the pass across the crease leads to a goal. Beautiful pass right there. And Springfield cuts the lead to 5-4. They're within a goal with just under 6 remaining. Let's cue up a replay here because this was nice. Domi. What's Domi doing down here too? You got a lot of youngsters that should be up helping the big club. Instead, they're down here wasting their time away, I guess, in the minors. But what a pass by Domi. The goaltender, no chance whatsoever. And it's now 5-4. So the ensuing faceoff at center ice. They're going to win this. Kick it back to the D. Let's get it in the zone. Here we go. Domi once again. Domi is going to pass in front. And it's Courtnell putting it home. We are tied at 5 as Courtnell scores again. The momentum clearly back in Springfield's favor now, as they score 2 rapid-fire goals, and this time it's Courtnell's second of the game. Domi setting up teammates left and right, as you see this pass zipped right in front, and Courtnell gets enough of it to put it past the goaltender. Did it go 5-hole? Looks like he may have beat him stick side one way or another. He's able to put it in the net for his second goal. We go to overtime now in 3-on-3. Very exciting hockey. Got to be careful here not to give up odd man rushes with so few people on the ice waiting for teammates here. He's going to go into the corner, maybe behind the net. The pass in front. Oh, great kick save. But the rebound is in. Courtnall gets the hat trick and ends the game in overtime. His backhander knocked the water bottle right off the top of the net, and with emphasis, he ends this game. What a comeback for the Falcons. They really kind of stunk up the middle of this game, going from a 3-1 lead down 5-3, but they come back, tie it up, and win it in overtime, and Russ Courtnall has a hat trick. They almost got the goal on his pass in front there with the kick save, but they kept coming at the net in waves. And Russ Courtnall, your number one star, 3 goals and an assist. What a game for him. As are we watching Arizona? Are we ready to call this kid back up? Come on. He's performing down here and he's ready. Next up, we're taking the Providence Bruins on. And they are scoring first here in the first period. Providence gets on the board. And, well, that's a goal he'd like back. He got a piece of it, but not enough. Jump ahead to second period action and Springfield on the break. Courtnall unleashes a slap shot, but that is a save and he holds on to it. Still 1-0, and let's make that 2-0 Providence as they get a goal midway through the second period. Here's Courtnall entering the zone. He's hit, but he keeps the puck. He gets it to a teammate who puts it on net, but another save, keeping the shutout intact at this point. Providence scores another goal. It's 3-0. We go into the third period now. Needing to rally, getting this puck in the Providence zone. Courtnall is not going to get the puck. That goes to a teammate, and he puts it in the net. So we do get our first goal. And it is now 3-1. See if we can mount a comeback in the third period, kind of like our last game. However, time is ticking away, under 5 minutes now. We got a rush and a chance, and the puck put on net by Courtnall, but it's another save, and he will not give up a rebound. Basically, what Courtnall was hoping for there was a juicy rebound they could put in. But Springfield loses this one 3-1 to the Providence Bruins. And it will go down as a loss. So we move forward now from that one, and we're going to be taking on the Portland Pirates. Just hoping at this point that when we get through this 5-game evaluation period, they'll decide to bring him back up to the NHL. That is definitely the wishful thinking version of things here. Portland gets the first goal, and it's 1-0. And here is a face-off win. Courtnall puts it on net. It is sticked aside behind the net, working on getting possession back. And they do the pass in front, and it's a goal. Glove side, short side, it's in the net. And Springfield has tied this at 1. Good goal right there. And I tell you, 31 is quite a beast. I can never say that name, but let's just call him Brendan. All right, way to go, Brendan. Makes this a 1-1 game. That's a face-off win for Portland, however, and it ends up in our net. Frustrating right there. Don't want to lose face-offs in your zone too often because stuff like that can happen. So now we got to try to get this tied up again here in the first period. Courtnall in the zone. He's waiting. Feeds a teammate, and he scores. Nice pass for the assist right there. And this game is tied at 2. Courtnall kind of just hesitated, waiting for a teammate to become available and open, and he does not miss on the pass, and the puck put in the net. 2-2 game. Courtnall gets his first assist of this game. Nice redirection right into the net right there, and we are all tied up. First period still going on, though. Over the boards is Courtnall, and well, there you go. Again on the ice just in time for the puck to go in his own net. Well, there you go. We're down 3-2 now. And we are into second period action. Working this off another face-off win. There's the save. The rebound trickles through his legs. And just that slowly crosses the goal line. It all counts the same. Didn't get enough of it to make the save. And it is 4-2 Portland. That is a power play goal and some frustration setting in. But really no need to panic. There's a lot of game left here. A few minutes left in the second period and then on to the third. But here is a turnover in the Portland end, working this, and the shot is deflected once again. It's in the net, and does Courtnall get credit for this one again? Is it another deflection goal for the youngster? I believe so. One way or another, it's 4-3, and yes, it is Russ Courtnall's goal as he works in front. The shot from the point, and there's two players right there. But it's going to be Courtnall redirecting that in the net. Right in front there, you see it. And he gets credit for his first goal of the night. We're down to just a 3 minutes to play now. Courtnall hopping on that puck, and here they go. Trying to get a rush down the ice. Desperation time. But he sets up his man, and he scores! He scores! We're tied at four. Courtnall makes the pass, and the puck is put home. And with just 3 minutes and 2 seconds to play, we have a brand new hockey game. It's Brendan again. All right. Courtnall setting up Brendan, and he's getting the goal. I don't know. I think I asked you guys last time, how do you say that last name? I don't know if anyone knows. I guess I didn't really check to see if you guys had any pronunciation guide, but that looks like a tricky name. I'm going to let it be. Anyway, we're into overtime. We've been here before in this episode. 3-on-3 again. Nice passing by Springfield. Puck put on the net, and it's in. The game's over, except wait. They've waved this off, and for good reason, because when you see the replay, Courtnall, not sure if he got shoved into the net to start with, but he couldn't get out of there. He's in the crease and affecting the goaltender's chance to make a save there. They wipe that off, and that is the correct call. So Courtnall thought they had ended it, but unfortunately, because he's standing in the crease, we got to play some more. This ended up going to the shootout. Courtnall's the second shooter for Springfield, waiting to tee it up. Here we go. I'm not much of a deker here, but I'm hoping backhand to forehand will go, and it does. He's able to get this goal five hole, and it's the first goal of the shootout. So Courtnall scores. Who knows? Maybe it's the only goal of the shootout. We haven't seen one before this. Let's see if his goaltender can stand up big with one more opportunity to tie this up. Portland hoping to extend this to another round, but no, the save. And the game is over. Delayed reaction there, but Springfield realizes they've won the game in a shootout. Okay, Courtnall once again factoring huge in the decision, getting the game-winning goal in the shootout. So he was contributing in the NHL with the Coyotes before being sent down. He's contributing here in Springfield. I don't know what else you can ask for him. Again, the number one star with a goal and two assists, and another goal that doesn't go on the score sheet there, at least officially, because it was a shootout goal, but it was the winner. Hey, he's getting moved up to the first line. Well, I guess that's good news. He wanted the call back to the NHL, but I guess this is a step in the right direction. First line now, as he should have been all along, and now a 73 overall. We'll come back next time with more Russ Courtnall and see if we can get back to the Coyotes. We'll see you then. Thanks for watching. If you enjoyed the video, go ahead and join the SGU team. Subscribe right here on YouTube to get daily videos from SGU, as well as frequent live streaming events. Give us a follow on Twitter for up-to-the-minute information on channel uploads. And last but not least, check out the SGU Facebook page. So what are you waiting for? Join in on the fun today!